now it's time for today's guest. Nicky Paris has been named a comic to watch by the Huffington Post as he breaks down barriers and captivates audiences in the comedy scene. He's best known for his appearances on The Wendy Williams Show, MTV, Lifetime, and more. Today he joins us to talk about his upcoming gigs at the New York Comedy Festival. Please give a warm Build Brunch welcome to Nicky Paris.
Hi, nice to meet you.
I'm gonna give you a hug, Lucas.
How are you?
Come on, bring it in. Good morning.
Hi.
Hi, beautiful. How are you? Good to see you.
Good to see you.
I'm giving a hug all around. Oh, good morning. Hi.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Welcome to the table.
Thank you.
Nicky coming in with the energy.
I know.
Oh, I'm bringing it.
Now I feel like every person we've interviewed in the past has been asleep.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, let's just talk about the acoustic performance that we just heard, the a cappella.
You want me to start?
Yeah.
I was gonna bring my triangle. And
my God.
And Lucas, me and every gay man in New York City, the song from Wicked is called What Is This Feeling?
Oh, sorry, right.
What is this feeling? Loathing.
Damn.
How dare you?
No!
How dare you?
So well!
Oh, me and Bette Midler are pissed.
Yeah. Can you just like stick Twitter on him? Send us some Twitter hate. He also because he needs more followers.
Yeah, I need more followers.
News is good news.
The Wicked fans right
Wicked
here.
Wicked fans, follow right me and troll me. Just send me a bunch of Wicked memes, videos. Go for it.
I heard loathing and I went, gulp.
I love that you just called him out for that.
I just think I'm going to be a gay mafia's after me now, right?
We're going to hit you with a baton, so be careful.
There you go.
You're in danger.
I love this.
Nicky, you are a very, very hilarious and talented stand-up comedian.
Likewise.
Tell us how you got into this journey and sort of what your experience with stand-up has been like so far.
So everyone my whole life was like, you should be a comedian, you should be a comedian. I wanted to be Britney Spears, but I have a muffin top and I can't sing. So that I had to let that dream die. I did stand-up for the first time when I was 17 on a cruise ship. And it was kind of an accident. It was an open mic, I had nothing prepared, and I just went up there. And I winged it, and I caught the bug. Mm. Not crabs, stand up. and it's been a journey ever since. I perform all the time, and it's been truly, it changed my life.
Yeah.
I'm very lucky.
And are you based in LA?
Yeah, I just moved to LA in January.
Oh, wow. Ooh.
Now I'm a plus size model.
Oh,
right,
man.
Right here. I have the muffin top to prove it.
That's not true. So I've heard that various comedy clubs loved you, said you were fantastic, but said that they couldn't use you as a house comic because you were gay.
That was actually here in New York.
New York.
Yeah.
So how did you overcome that? What was that experience like?
I said, I'll take my Louis Vuitton bag and go somewhere else. And that's exactly what I did. There was comedy clubs that said, we think you're hilarious, but because of who you are, we can't use you at this club.
Are you serious?
And I was like, Italian? Like, what do you mean by that? I was so confused at first. But yeah, a lot of people still, comedy is still in some places very much blue collar, and a lot of people still feel that way. So, if one door doesn't open, you put on a new pair of shoes and you knock down the next one, okay?
Woo!
Ladies and gentlemen.
Good for you.
Absolutely. And right now, tell us a little about what you're doing in LA. You're opening for Mean Girls, Daniel.
Francesi,
yes.
Yeah.
Francesi.
I love, do you guys love Mean Girls?
Huge.
Yes.
Yeah. I was going to say, are you even American?
So, Damien, hello.
Hello, right? Yeah. So he is fantastic. We perform together all the time. We have a show in December at Flappers Comedy Club. It's Danny Francesi and Friends. And he has kind of been like my first famous friend in LA. Mm-hmm. All right, do you guys love the Cheesecake Factory?
Of course.
Oh my God.
Oh, again,
we were talking about it.
All right.
Yeah.
So if you go to the Cheesecake Factory, you have to like dine out. It's like a 12-hour excursion. You bring a tent. He walks
bring your
in
passport.
There and he gets a celebrity code.
What?
He goes to the counter and he says, Mr. Cheesecake.
Oh.
And they give you a table. I said, I've never met Mr. Cheesecake. I've spent thousands of dollars at the Cheesecake Factory, so I love him.
Oh my God!
Even in LA, the Cheesecake Factory are just stars.
Yeah, no, I bring pajamas, clothes for the next week. Like, I will camp out there for the Cheesecake Factory. But he gets to walk right in, so whenever I have to go, I'm like, okay, we'll all go, we'll call him.
Yeah.
Like, tell Mr.
What's
Cheesecake.
What's your cheesecake of choice?
I like the Godiva one.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah. I eat like a pregnant woman, so Godiva, and I also like the lemon raspberry.
Oh,
good one.
Are you sponsoring the show Cheesecake Factory?
We're not giving you any plugs. Anyone could be a sponsor.
Right.
We love cheesecake.
Please, and I love the New Orleans pasta, so send it right here.
We're getting Junior's cheesecake tomorrow on the show. That's why I asked.
Oh,
yeah. You can come back.
Okay.
You can come back.
I'll sleep here, just like at the Cheesecake Factory. I don't care.
So a lot of your fans know and love you from your Wendy Williams segments.
Yeah.
So how did that experience sort of change your career?
They were looking for people, edgy people with an opinion, and I think that's me, clearly. And I think I've done probably like 20 episodes on just like different hot topics. It was when I was in college, which is kind of crazy.
Yeah, so I interned there in 2014.
No way.
Yeah, so I wonder if it overlapped. I mean, I was just seeing
I wish I
people.
Could meet you then yeah. and tell you the song is called What Is This Feeling? Oh. I wish I could bring it back. No, I...
My biggest regret of my life.
No, it was really cool. Like, I remember I had a final for college and I told the teacher, I'm gonna be on the Wendy Williams show today. I don't know if you're familiar with Wendy, my Aunt Wendy, but I'm not coming today. So it was a really great experience. And I just love talking about entertainment and pop culture. So any chance I get to do that, I will take. I will be there.
Yeah. And you mentioned you started pretty young. So who were some of the comedians you really looked up to?
Oh, Joan Rivers.
Oh yes.
My God, me too.
And I actually played Joan Rivers last week at right? Dead yeah. Comedians Night at Flappers. Oh. So that was interesting. Wow. You know, I've never dressed as a woman. Despite popular belief, gay men, okay? And when I was getting ready, I bought like a blonde wig and I had, you know, the glitter jacket and the jewels and the diamonds and people were asking, they're like, who are you? And I was like, no, I'm Joan Rivers. Like, it's Dead Comedians Night, but it was a lot of fun.
Did you do the voice?
I tried, yeah. Oh. I was like, it's my daughter here, Melinda, Melissa, whatever. Vaginas drop, you know, I tried my best.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, she was so definitely great. Been one of my inspirations
yeah,
for sure.
Yeah, absolutely.
And you have a crazy story. So a CNN reporter contacted you,
oh my God.
And you happened to be at Disney when you found out that guy who was sending bombs in the mail, you were one of his targets. He, like, put you on a list.
Yeah, how was your week?
Yeah.
Right? How about that?
So that's insane.
You, Secretary Clinton, President yeah. Obama, have all been targeted by this crazy man. How do you feel now?
Yeah, I only got a tweet, and I'm a little upset. Next year, I'm hoping for a bomb.
Oh, God.
I have tickets to sell, like New York Comedy Festival, on November 7th at 8 p.m. But, yeah, I found out a couple of weeks ago, me and Kathy Griffin were tweeting, and he sent a threat to the both of us on Twitter. So I didn't think really anything of it because I don't really look at, you know, I skim Twitter. Mm-hmm. And then I was online at It's a Small World on Monday. I was in Disneyland in California. And I found out on A Small World that I was part of a small threat.
Whoa.
And yeah, so they were like, are you okay? Like, we just want to let you know what happened. He's now arrested. So it was really upsetting.
Wow.
But I called my poor mother and I was like, I'm the victim of a bombing. She was like, really? She was like, your stand-up? I was like, no, like an actual bomb.
Your mom sounds funny.
Yeah, she's something else.
Well, do you think, that kind of gets back to being a comedian now in the Trump era. Do you feel like now, because it's happened to you, you're a little more afraid to be as outspoken? Or
no.
You're like, fuck that, I'm going
to
go for
I
it.
Could use the press. So if anybody wants to do anything to me, I will be willing and available. No, it's a weird time to do stand-up
right.
in the Trump era because everybody's so upset. I try not to go too deep into politics
yeah.
because I feel like you go to see comedy to laugh and be happy and have an escape. Like, you don't want to leave more upset.
Totally.
Yeah. If I want to make people upset, I'll do my stand-up topless. So, you know, no reason for that.
So you're also, you're performing at the New York Comedy Festival, the Stonewall mm-hmm. Inn, on November 7th.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us about that and how?
Yeah, Ali's
I know
Ali's
show.
Yeah,
too.
The both of us.
Both
right?
So this is
That's
it.
Right.
Guys, you can see both of them in one night.
Two for one special, like Tia and Tamara.
I mean.
Which, as people often describe you as, is
yeah.
the new
yeah. Yeah.
Tamara.
Yeah.
We've gotten
people are yelling at us, actually in here on the street. It was like, please, just let us in. Yeah, it's, you know, the Stonewall is a historic gay landmark, yeah. and I'm really excited for the show. It's produced by Chrissy Mayer, and there's some of the best future gay comedians of tomorrow, so definitely come out and see us next week. I'm really excited.
I'm excited.
Yes.
Ooh, yeah.
That's so exciting. I can't wait.
I know.
It's been so great to have you.
Thank you for having
you
me.
Guys,
this has been a blast.